Sanjeev Stalin, left fullback, India.
We were first spotted by Jamshed Nasiri.
Yes.
He also played for East Bengal. So how did he come to know about you?
No, actually, there was a tournament in Bangalore.
Okay.
So I was playing in that tournament. I was the youngest boy in the tournament. So it was the last game of mine. And in that tournament, it was the last game of mine.
Uh-huh.
So I had a free kick, the same situation. I had a free kick. There was no throw-in that time.
Okay.
It's a small-sided game.
Okay.
5v5.
Okay.
So the throw-in has to be taken as a free kick.
Yeah.
So I just get the ball. I didn't know. I thought I'm going to pass to my brother.
Okay.
But by God's grace, it went into the net. So he after the game, he called me. He said, "What's your name? Where you're from?" I just said, "I'm Sanjeev Stalin. I'm the local boy of Bangalore."
Okay.
So he said.
So you were spotted in Bangalore, is it?
Yes, he said you have a bright future if you go to Chandigarh Football Academy.
Okay.
So he called my father, and rest is.
Rest is history. So how did that actually happen? Like, from when did you start playing football? Do you remember any faintly, like when you started? How do you started?
I keep on telling to everybody, football is in my blood because of my father. Because my father is a really good footballer, and because of him and his blessings, football, I came to know what is football, and that is my father. Even my mother's brother, he really supports me, and he is a football fan. He's a really big football fan, and he owns a shop in the footpath. Shop is a shop.
Shop is
no
a shop.
Matter a footpath,
yes.
Showroom, nothing, because he is really passionate about football.
Mm-hmm.
So he helps me a lot, and because of my father, I came to know what is football. And Chandigarh Football Academy just modified me.
Okay.
Actually, I played as a midfielder over there. Everybody came to know there.
Uh-huh.
I was the midfielder. Then I became a striker, then a winger, then now as a fullback.
So at the age of 11, to be precise, you travelled to Chandigarh living back home, then you went there, then you were into Chandigarh Football Academy, is it?
Yes, at the age of 10, at the age of 10. Then when I became 11, they called me.
Uh-huh.
They said, "Oh, you're going to be part of Chandigarh Football Academy."
Okay.
That time we were 10 boys. A few of them were Punjabis.
Uh-huh.
And two of them were Manipuri. In that, Amarjit also was there. Amarjit Jackson.
Amarjit, who was the captain under 17.
Prabhsukan Gill.
Uh-huh.
And rest of them. I know everybody's name. Dalbir, Harpreet Singh Sandhu, Anil, everybody's name, the 10 boys.
Uh-huh.
Later, when it was 1 year, then the team were packed, you know. Rest of the boys, the team were really together, 21 players. So they began the story. First 2 years, I was.
This
just,
was in what? Which year you are talking about?
2011, 2012. The first 2 years, I was just in the wall, a big wall, actually, a goalpost size wall, with a ball.
Okay.
Everybody. I really thank Harjinder Singh sir and Sandeep sir.
Sandeep sir.
Okay.
And Harjinder Singh was your first coach.
Yes, he was.
So how important was he for you during the initial days of your career?
First coach was my father. Harjinder Singh sir was really a big changeover for me, because he is the person who taught what is professional football is.
Okay.
And he just said, "We have a ball over there."
Mm-hmm.
He gave us the ball. He said, "2 years you have to just keep on playing with the ball, not with the players, with the ball."
So just throw the ball onto the wall,
yes,
and
because
then
he
keep
needs
playing with
first,
the
basic rule of football is control, ball control. If you don't know what is ball control, then maybe for me, I don't know football so big as mature, no.
Mm-hmm.
But still a few things. If you don't have ball control, maybe we can't play football. So for him, it was a first thing for him. Then later on, we had a lot of matches with the seniors, our senior.
Uh-huh. Senior in what age group you are talking
about? Yes, we were younger.
Younger.
In Chandigarh Football Academy, there's two batch, okay?
Uh-huh.
One is senior and one is junior.
One is
and
junior.
We were in the junior batch.
Junior batch.
So we used to have...
So you, Amarjit...
Amarjit, Sukan, Jackson...
So they're all in the same
Sumit,
group?
Yes. Everybody were in junior batch.
Okay.
So senior batch was Daniel, Nishu, who's playing the Bangalore...
Nishu Kumar.
Samuel, okay. Arjit...
So they all trained with you guys in Chandigarh Football Academy?
We have different fields, right? Used to train in a different field, and they used to train in a different field. But on Saturdays, we used to have a match because we need to develop, right? If you play against the stronger opponents, we obviously get developed. So our coach mentality was that, and later on, rest was God's blessings.
So you were called the specialist for dead balls, like taking free kicks, corner kicks. So when did you realize that you are very good at it?
As I said, when I was playing the tournament, Jamshednas sir said me.
Yeah.
That time, just feel okay. Even I can take free kicks also, but I didn't really focus on that. And later on, when I went to Chandigarh Football Academy, there was a lot of goalkeeper called Niraj. He's one of my best friend.
Okay.
So I used to take him separately, and even Jaskaran. We used to. Right now he's in under 16 team.
Mm-hmm.
So we used to take him separately, and I used to practice my free kicks with him. I used to challenge him, if out of 5 I scored 3, then he has to buy something for me.
Okay. So that was a challenge which you guys did.
The challenge was making me strong. Maybe right now I'm not specialist, to be honest. Yes, I have to work more. I have to work every day on that. And to become something, we have to work hard.
Yeah.
If not, maybe just the name, Sanjeev Stalin is a free kick specialist. If I don't deliver on the field, the name will slowly go down and it will be disappeared. So I don't want that to happen. So I have to work hard a lot.
So you are in the history books of Indian football because you have an assist in a World Cup game. So can you tell me the story behind it? Like, how did it happen? Did you know any, do you remember anything during that game when you took a corner?
I remember every minute of that. But after scoring goal, I promise, I don't remember. Because of that atmosphere, because of the fans, supporters, which we had, unbelievable. And seriously, when I took the corner, I remember a few things. I remember my cross, which foot I used, everything. But after scoring goal, that was a different feeling, my friend. No money can buy that.
So you were drafted into Indian team. So India under 17. When did you realize that they are? When did you realize that you would be part of the Indian squad for the coming World Cup?
As I said, we had a training session over there. I mean, in Goa. After the later, we came to know that we are going to play against the preparation of under 17 World Cup team in 2014-15 something. So we had the 2 games. In the 2 games, I scored both. I scored in every both the games. So I was playing as a striker over there. In that, five of them got selected. First game we had a draw game, 1-1. First goal I scored, and the second goal, the AFF team scored. And in the second game, we won by 3-1. So after the game, we came to know that 5 boys got selected. Me, Amarjeet, Sumit, Harsh and Karan. So later on, slowly, I came to the team.
And so that's how it's been journey to Indian under 17. How was the preparation for this?
I was in a B team, you know. I got injured.
B team of what?
There were 2 teams, A team and B team.
Okay.
So first, when Nikolai Adam sir arrived, that time I was not known to him, you know. He don't know me because I didn't play. I was injured. Okay. So the coach of Indian team that time. He said, you're injured, let the other boy get chance. So he got chance of, not in my position, because he deserves what he gets.
Okay.
So I was injured, maybe that time is not my time. And slowly later on, when I was back on the field.
Okay.
Nikolai sir saw me. The next day, I called my father. Said, I don't know why, everything is not perfect for me this time. He said, don't worry. Your talent will show and your hard work will give you what you need. So he said, have patience. He said, I'll come tomorrow, we'll talk. That time he was in Bangalore. When I called him, he said, I'll come tomorrow to Goa.
Okay.
So when he came to Goa, I didn't train.
Oh, you didn't train that day?
Yeah,
you were off that day?
Listen, I didn't train. Then one of my teammates said, uncle, Sanjeev is not training today. He said, why? Because he's going to be part of A team.
Okay. Oh, that's a surprise, is
it? A big surprise for me because his words means a lot to me and motivation for me. So the next day I went to training. Nikolai sir was impressed. He said me, believe me, you have a great future. You have one of best technique. You know, foot. You have best technique, and you are quick. Hmm. Then he started liking me slowly. Slowly I performed well, and rest I came into the team. And in Norway, we didn't have fullback, left fullback.
So this is for the before the preparation of the World Cup, yes. You're talking about.
But in Norway, after.
So you guys traveled to Norway for a training.
Now I was in the team. I'm in the perfect position.
Okay.
Not perfect position.
So you're playing in which position?
Winger right now.
Right
now. As a
right winger.
Right winger.
So you were playing on the both the wings,
both
either
the wings,
either
yes,
of
yes,
them.
Yes. But in Norway, we didn't have fullbacks.
Okay.
So he got injured.
Uh-huh.
So the coach said, would you like to try? I said, okay sir, why not? So he said, you try, if not, no worries, I will support you.
Mm-hmm.
Then I really thank Nikolai sir.
So he turned you into a fullback?
Yes, no matter what the people say, but for me, he changed where I was. Sanjeev Stalin, okay, as a fullback, everybody came to recognize me. And he really supported me. If I do mistakes in the position fullback, mm-hmm. as a fullback, he used to support me. Okay, this is a new position, no worries. If you do after 1 year the same mistake, maybe that time I'll scold you. But he used to not scold, he used to just put pressure on us.
Yeah.
So that really made me a stronger person inside. And he was really good to me.
So how was your experience for India Under 17 World Cup? You obviously played in it, being part of the success journey that India had. So what about your thoughts on the crowds? How did you guys manage to hold your nerves on such a big crowd and big games?
Look, pressure is two types for me. One is good and one is bad pressure. I only keep my good things, which makes me stronger. Bad pressure, leave it behind. Maybe after the game, it doesn't matter. For me, only on the field. If my good pressure is making me playing perfect and giving me a performance, then I will take my good pressure. Why not? So pressure is two types. And everybody needs pressure. If you don't have pressure enough, then you won't perform well.
So, that's hard to digest, like someone like a 17-year-old talking. It's like it shows volumes about your maturity of these things. So I think that was a great experience for
yes,
you guys. So how do you handle it, like the crowd behind you guys? So would that be a potent pump in you guys, saying that yeah, we got to do it for them?
Very very much, because nobody gets this much, and nobody gets the special thing. You know, the fans and the supporters, everybody. Everybody in the world needs them, no matter he's educated or not, no matter he's a sports person or not, no matter he's special or not. Everybody needs fans. No matter fans, it's a family also.
Yeah.
So we need support.
So you get connected to them,
yes,
automatically
very much,
once
very much.
They're there.
I trust them a lot, because without them football is nothing, and without football we are nothing. So.
Yeah. So how is it like you have come from the grassroots level right from the scratch, you have made your own journey, so how mentally is that toll on you? Or
maybe
how
not grassroots, mud root.
Mud root, yeah, that's also a truth.
Because I used to play in the mud field.
So how that has made you a mentally a tough person, or going ahead, like you work on your challenges?
I used to not have football shoes.
Uh-huh.
I used to have football shoes, but I used to not wear in the mud ground. Everybody used to play barefoot, right?
Yeah.
So they used to be scared if I step on them. So even I used to not wear them.